In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. The scriptures today remind us that God's love is stronger than death. And God's desire for us is to have life, life to the full. So let's call upon His mercy and His forgiveness. Lord Jesus, you came to call sinners. Lord, have mercy. Christ Jesus, by your death, you rescued us from death. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God the Father. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversity, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God formed man to be imperishable. The image of his own nature, he made them. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world. And they who are in his possession experience it. But the souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead. And their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if he before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them. And as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. I will bless the Lord at all times. The Lord has eyes for the just and ears for their cry. The Lord confronts the evildoers to destroy remembrance of them from the earth. I will bless the Lord at all times. When the just cry out, the Lord hears them, and from all their distress, he discusses them. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted, and those who are crushed in spirit, he saves. I will bless the Lord at all times.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him, and we will come to him. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to the apostles, "Who among you would say to your servant who has just come in from plowing or tending sheep in the field, 'Come here immediately and take your place at table'? Would he not rather say to him, 'Prepare something for me to eat. Put on your apron and wait on me while I eat and drink. You may eat and drink when I am finished.' Is he grateful to that servant because he did what was commanded? So should it be with you. When you have done all you have been commanded, say, 'We are unprofitable servants. We have done what we were obliged to do.'" The Gospel of the Lord. We have this wonderful reading from the Book of Wisdom, a reading that we often hear at funerals. Although at funerals, the reading usually begins with "the souls of the just are in the hand of God," and it leaves out those sentences beforehand, which are so important. A reminder to us that God formed us to be imperishable. God formed us in his own image. So we are created for eternal life. We are created to reflect the image of God, and it's because of that that our lives are stronger than death, and even more so because of Jesus, death and resurrection, we are people destined for life. You know, this sense of life after death in the Old Testament, in the Hebrew Scriptures, is kind of vague. It's only much later in the development of the Old Testament that there's talk of life after death. Here in the Book of Wisdom, also in the Book of Job, you see it, and you see it in the Book of Maccabees, the most explicit sense of life after death, resurrection. But we who are disciples of Jesus know even more clearly that we're destined for eternal life. We're destined for resurrection. We are destined for that by our own baptism. In a sense, for us as Christians, eternal life doesn't begin after we die physically. Eternal life begins through our baptism. And so in a way, we're already living eternal life, a life that will continue as we stay closer to God, as we remain in the hand of God throughout our life. We'll ultimately be raised up with Jesus as we stay faithful to him. Because in our baptism, as St. Paul reminds us, we have died with Christ. We were buried with Christ in baptism, and we are raised up with Christ. As one of my professors used to say to us, you know, basically what St. Paul is saying is, you're dead already, so why worry? You have nothing to worry about because you've already been immersed in the death of Jesus, and if you remain faithful to Jesus, you will be raised up. God's love, God's life is stronger than death. God's love and God's life is stronger than any tragedy that can happen to us. And so today, as we reflect on this passage from the Book of Wisdom, we're reminded that not only after death, but right now, we are in the hand of God, that God holds us by the hand, that God leads us through life, and God desires to lead us to life eternal in the resurrection. As the reading ends, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and God's care is with his elect, we're called to remember that God's grace and mercy is with us, and God's care is with us, and even now, God holds us by the hand. Trusting in God, we offer our prayers for ourselves, for one another, and for the whole world. We pray for the church, that we may be a sign of God's love, a sign of God's life in this world, a sign that we are destined for the resurrection. We pray to the Lord. We pray for Pope Francis, for our bishops, for all those who have ministries of leadership in the church, that they may be guided by the Holy Spirit. We pray to the Lord. We pray for peace in the world, especially peace in the Holy Land, peace in Ukraine. We pray that world leaders may work tirelessly for peace. We pray for all those who are in the midst of war, especially innocent civilians, that God may protect them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have recently lost loved ones, those who are in mourning. We pray that their hope in the resurrection may be strengthened. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who are sick, all those you know who need God's healing. We pray that they may have peace, that they may know God close to them. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who have died. We pray for Richard Hall. The Mass is offered for Richard Hall, Deborah Schaff's brother. We pray for all those whose names have been placed on the altar, all of our loved ones who have gone before us. We pray for Michael Smestad, for Chip Fortin, for Jerry Chiraris, for Matthew, for Bob and Daniel, for Ronald and Elizabeth. We pray for Bernadette Zarles, Chris Tabora, and all of our loved ones who have gone before us, that they may be raised up in God's presence. We pray to the Lord. And for all the prayers that we hold in our hearts, we pause for a moment in silence. We pray to the Lord. Loving God, you are the source of life. You are the source of peace. We ask you to look upon our needs and receive these prayers, for we trust in you and we pray through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice and our lives may be acceptable to God, the loving Father. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. And giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Leonard, our Bishop, Christopher, our coadjutor bishop, all the clergy, and all who minister to your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At our Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. May the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us all together to everlasting life. Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those your heavenly power has entered. Through Christ our Lord. So, in case you haven't had the chance, there's still time to write the names of your deceased relatives and friends. There are sheets on, by the side door and in the back, and place them on the altar. We will pray for them for the rest of the month of October, which is the month of the Holy Souls. Also, if there are people you know who have died this year from January until now, you can enter their names in our Book of the Dead, and we'll remember them. So feel free to do that. If you're interested, there's still time to order pies for Thanksgiving from the Grotto Cafe. There are some sheets in the back that talk about it. You can do the order online, or you can just call Montford House and order them over the phone. So the information is in the back there. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father and Son and Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
Thank you. Have a good day.